السلام عليكم.
Whenever you do commit any wrong, then at least follow it up with a good deed that will erase the ill effect of your sin. Now, in theory, we all know what is wrong. I don't have to tell you, you don't have to tell me. You know the things that are forbidden. إِنَّ اللَّهَ فَرَضَ فَرَائِضَ فَلَا تُضَيِّعُوهَا وَحَدَّ حُدُودًا فَلَا تَعْتَدُوهَا وَسَكَتَ عَنْ عَشْيَاءَ رَحْمَةً لَكُمْ غَيْرَ نِسْيَانٍ فَلَا تَبْحَثُوا عَنْهَا. Allah has ordained limits and Allah has made certain things obligatory and certain things forbidden. But for whatever reason, we succumb to that wrong and we commit it. So you know Saturday night, you shouldn't be messing around with that girl, but for whatever reason, you did it. You shouldn't be gambling, but you gamble. You shouldn't be involved in interest, but you have. My message is to you not to provoke you or advocate to you to commit the sin. But my message to you is that if you have committed the wrong, my brother, there is still hope. There is still hope. There was a sister here from North America, from Canada. I hope she is here, and if she's not here, may Allah take my message to her. She had sent me an email, and I praise her and I compliment her. And it brought tears to my eyes. She said, Sheikh, I had led a life unmindful of Allah and oblivious of Allah. And I have tattoos on my body. And now I have regretted and I want direction in my life. My question is, will my Allah accept my prayers like this or not? My sister, yes, Allah will accept your prayers. Ya sahib al-dhanbi la taqnatinna fa innal ilaha ra'ufun ra'uf. O sinner, don't despair, you are dealing with a kind Allah. O sinner, I don't want any man or any sister to walk out despondent. I want every brother to walk out of here with hope that there is a future for him. What does Allah say? وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا فَعَلُوا فَاحِشَةً أَوْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ ذَكَرُوا اللَّهَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ. Those who, when they commit a wrong, they reflect. It hurts them, it haunts them, it bothers them. And they turn to Allah and seek for forgiveness. And who is there besides Allah that can forgive? Two things I'll mention about this ayah. When this verse was revealed, the devil cried. That he said, as long as the believers have this concession, I have no hope. And Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said, هَذِهِ الْآيَةِ خَيْرٌ لِأَهْلِ الذُّنُوبِ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. There is nothing that can give more solace to the sinner than this verse. There's nothing that can give more comfort to the perpetrator than this verse. Whatever your crime is, be you an adulterer or an adulteress, be you a thief or a thug, be you whatever, as long as you repent sincerely to Allah, this verse say Allah's doors are open for you. And really speaking, you know, at times, creation makes us appreciate how merciful Allah is.
مر الزمان تألقا وأضاء للدنيا طريقا مشرقا وهدى من الرحمن يهدينا به للصالحات وللمكارم والتقى.